Hello, everyone. How are you guys doing? How's everybody doing in YouTube land this day, this evening, or this night, whatever time of the day it is that you are watching? So welcome, welcome, welcome. Happy Thanksgiving Eve to everyone out there, to all of my aunties, uncles, nieces, and nephews. Welcome back, family. So welcome. So I wanted to come on this Thanksgiving Eve before I really get knee deep into cooking this evening. And I wanted to come on and talk to you guys because a lot of you are going to go shopping tomorrow. You're going to start shopping Friday. You might even do Cyber Monday shopping. You might wait till then. And I feel like right now, this is the time to tell you guys about different gear and things like that that you should be getting if you're thinking about starting a YouTube channel in 2023. I know there are a lot of people on this platform that share with you guys different things about gossip, about commentary, but at the end of the day, the information they should be sharing is how to start a YouTube channel, because in 2023, you're going to need some coins, you're going to need some duckies. There are a lot of us that are going to be laid off next year, and right now is a time to start thinking about what type of channel you want to start, okay? It's not about being a mogul. It's not about being a business person or anything like that. It's simply about getting a check, okay? And how can you make an extra stream of income to buy the things you want and do the things you want, regardless of the recession or depression or deflation or whatever the hell it is that's going on? You need to have another stream of income coming in that when those situations happen, you know what to do, okay? So I wanted to come on and share with you guys some of the gear that I use, not necessarily my live streaming gear. I'm telling y'all the stuff for my live streaming, I have spent over at least $3,500 to $4,000 on, okay? That's just my live streaming gear. That's not counting my cameras for vlogging. That's not counting my drone. I am a tech nut. I have gimbals for my cameras. I have gimbals for my phone. I have accessories for my car. I have tons of stuff when it comes to gear, okay? And I've just remembered that in my Amazon store, which I'm going to put the link to my Amazon affiliate store in the description box so you guys can find these items. I need some water that I'm going to be discussing, okay, in this video, like my box lights. And one of the things that YouTubers don't share with y'all is they don't use just the box lights and the lights that come in the box. It's some different type of light bulbs that they use that keep it from being hot, okay? So I want to share those things with you because we have now upgraded from using ring lights. We've upgraded from using your cell phone. And I'm going to tell you why starting with your cell phone is good, but you need to invest in an actual camera. I'm going to be explaining SD cards in this video. I'm going to be explaining what camera I decided to go with to vlog. And I'm actually going to be buying another camera for vlogging, but I haven't tried it yet. So that way I can't really recommend it to y'all. But the one I have tried. But I invest in my craft. I don't come on here with fuzzy cameras. I don't come on here with janky ass audio. I'm going to invest in my craft. So most of the money I make from YouTube, I invest it right back into my brand. Okay. And I've been like this for years. I've been doing YouTube. I've been doing YouTube since like 2009, 2010 or something like that. So I've been doing it for a long time and I've constantly over time worked on my craft. If you go and you watch my first video here on YouTube, child, it look a hot mess. Okay. But over the years, I've learned to invest in the brand so that way I can make money off of the brand and off of my quality. And it's paying off. Okay. Now, let's get into it. So I have two box lights. Okay. Just like Tammy was talking about, I have two box lights right here. I used to have a ring light right here. And there's another light that goes above me that sometimes I put on. But when I put that light on, I have to change the settings in my lighting. Now, I only use this lighting above during live stream. So that's something I'm going to share at Internet Street Summit. But The box lights is what we're going to talk about because that's what you need 101 for YouTube, okay? So the box lights are the standard box lights that you see everyone use, but I use different bulbs. I do not use the bulbs that come with the lights because back in the day when I used to do YouTube and I used to do my makeup and I would do makeup tutorials and things like that, it used to get hot as hell, okay? I would get done and I couldn't even see straight because the ring light would be blaring in my eye. And by the time I finished the video, all I saw was just light flashing in my eye. And then these lights would be so hot, flaming hot, that I couldn't take it. So there are special bulbs that I use. And like I said, when this video ends, I'm going to add them to the Amazon store because I forgot to add them in there. But these are special bulbs that I use specifically for this. They don't get hot. As you can see, they're not blaring in my eye. And I don't need a ring light. These light up my whole entire area perfectly. Okay? So if you want to start a YouTube channel and you need really good lighting, yes, you could use a ring light. But girl, you're going to go blind using that ring light every day. You may as well go it on and invest in really good lighting. Okay? The bulbs, I think the bulbs are no more than $20 or $30 a piece. But they are absolutely amazing. Okay? So... oh, no, you don't need to, Mr. Banks, okay? That's actually my dog's name. My dog, I don't know if I ever told y'all this. We have a little Yorkie, and his name is Mr. Banks. And the reason why we name him Mr. Banks is because Madison's nickname to all of our friends is Rachel Rich. Because they say Madison is out here living a Richie Rich life, okay, here in Las Vegas, because we don't have a babysitter. She has to go everywhere we go. So if we go to an expensive steakhouse, then she got to travel along with us, okay? So they say Madison is living the Rachel Rich life. So, okay, we call the dog Mr. Banks, okay? So let me tell y'all, it's just box lights. I'm going to show you guys everything in my Amazon store in a second, okay? So let me get this together. So the first thing I want to show you, most importantly, is your camera, okay? Now, as you can see, I'm filming on a camera. This camera I'm going to be introducing to this channel sometime this weekend. I'll be introducing this camera into my channel, okay, when I do my lives. But this camera right here is my vlogging camera, and I'm going to tell you why. I had another camera, a Canon. I do not like Canon. Canon is great for photography, but Canon is not great for video. Sony is your beast, is your workhorse. However, I just found another camera. Y'all think this makes sense? My coworkers think I'm crazy. I just bought this camera like 3 weeks ago, and I'm already going to buy another camera for Black Friday because it's on sale. Okay. And this camera, from what I saw from YouTube, it's a beast. But this one is a beast too for beginners. Okay. The other one is more complicated. Now, let me tell you why I like this camera. This camera is, and let me pull it up for y'all. Let me pull this up so y'all can see it real time. So when you go to my Amazon store, the link is in my description box. And mind you, it's an affiliate store, so I get a little commission, child. It ain't enough to buy a burger, okay? But this makes it easy enough where you guys can find all the things I'm talking about, instead of me putting a bunch of links all over the place. When you go to my Amazon store and you click right here on vlogging gear, you'll see everything right here, okay? And I'm going to add the light bulbs and the box lights that I use. And it's one more thing I'm going to mention that I'm going to add to this also because you have to have this, okay? So this is a Sony ZV-E10, okay? You see a lot of YouTubers have this camera right now. And it retails for $798 right now on Amazon, but I'm not sure if Amazon is going to drop the price for Black Friday. And let me give you a little tip. Everything that you want on Black Friday, you need to go and make your list. You see how it says add to list right here on the side? You need to go and add it to your list, okay? So that way when Black Friday hit, you don't have to go back searching all of these things. You could just go to your list and see what the prices have dropped and what's actually on sale. This camera right now, I believe at Best Buy, is actually going for I want to say $5.99. It's regular price like $7.99, but it's going for $5.99. Now, let me tell y'all about investing in your brand, okay? Let me tell you about investing in your brand and why this is important. If you go and you get the Sony ZV-1 or ZV, whatever the previous one was that everybody had, okay, with the Zeiss lens, it was a stationary lens, meaning the lens never could detach from the camera. So you were stuck with that camera and stuck with that lens as a vlogging camera. The reason why I went with the Sony ZV-E10, okay, even though I'm getting that other camera, let me tell you why. Because I am a Sony junkhead. Sony to me is the best quality video that you could find right now that I can use the same battery from this camera on my camera up here and vice versa, okay? But let me tell y'all, what's also awesome about this camera, okay? And let me tell you something. That Sony A5100 Nafi, and I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly. Nafi, that Sony A5100 is actually a really great starter camera as far as vlogging. The only difference between the Sony A5100 and this one, because the Sony A5100 was my first vlogging camera, and the quality on it was superb. I'm not even going to lie. When they discontinued that camera, I damn near cried. The Sony A5100, I believe, only goes to 1080p, so it doesn't record in 4K. When you're recording video for TikTok, Instagram, you know how you see a lot of people that their quality on their Instagrams are like superb? The reason being is because they are filming with this. They are not filming with an iPhone. They are filming with this. They will go on Instagram, and this is why I say these are the secrets they don't want you to know. They will go on Instagram and lie and tell y'all they filming with their iPhone on 4K, and they lying. A lot of them are filming with cameras like these, okay, and hooking it up to a monitor and being able to see what it is that they're doing, and then they're recording it in 4K and coming back and processing it, because when you film in 4K and you upload to a platform like Instagram or TikTok, they're going to compress your video. So if you're already filming at a 4K standard, by the time you compress it and put it into an Instagram or a TikTok, it's going to still have really high resolution of a 1080p. If you film in 1080p and then upload to TikTok or Instagram, it's going to compress it down to 720. Okay? If y'all understand numbers and things like that. Okay? So that's the thing with that camera. But what I tell you about this camera, let me tell y'all. This Sony EV10 is a beast because I have other lenses. Let me make sure I'm covering my lens because I don't need y'all in my business like that. This lens is my bomb lens, okay? This is the lens I use to take my pictures. Now, let me tell y'all how cool this camera is. This camera is lighter than my other camera. And what I can do is I can actually detach this lens, okay? I could put that lens down. I could take my other lens from my Sony camera that I use to do professional photo shots, because y'all know I do photography professionally. And I can attach this E-mount to this E-mount like this and use it, okay? Okay? This is why I like this camera, all right? So this camera is a beast. And that's why you need to invest in good quality stuff from the get-go, because you don't want to be stuck with a camera that can only do one thing. You want to get a camera that can do multi-functions that is not that expensive, because the camera I do my live streams on, that's like a $1,200 camera, okay? So I would rather pay $5.99 for a camera and get all the functions of using all my different lenses. My workhorse lenses, even the video that you're seeing now, is because I have a really good lens. I invest in lenses. The most I ever paid for a lens is the one that I'm recording on now, and that one was close to $1,000. So I invest in my brand, trust and believe, okay? And that's why I'm having Internet Street Summit, and that's why I'm charging what I'm charging for people to come, because at the end of the day, I've invested in my brand. And for you to know what it is that I do, you're going to have to invest in yours. And I don't do for free. I'm sorry. Them days of me sitting on the internet giving information for free that don't float no more. Okay. So that's why I won't say about my live stream and stuff. My live stream and stuff, I'm going to show y'all how to set it up at the conference. If you don't know, Internet Street Summit is live. This is not online. This is not a course. This is a summit. We are going to start from beginning to end, how to hook all this stuff up, how to actually go live. I'm going to show you how to do everything. Enough with this stuff of sitting on the internet, going to people courses, going to people classes, and they're not showing you how to physically do it. You got all this paperwork, all this stuff, but you don't know how to actually do it, okay? So that's what the event is about. Now, currently right now, if you go on the website and you pay upfront the full price, you get $100 off through Monday for Black Friday. If you're in the membership group, I put a coupon code for y'all in the membership group that you get $150 off, okay? But if you're doing it as a payment plan, I allowed it to go through Klarna and Afterpay. If you're doing via payment plan, then you just have to pay the full price because I'm allowing you to break it up into payments, okay? But getting back to the gear, this is a beast of a camera, okay? As you can see, the screen on it is huge, and it has a big, huge red box that comes up when you actually press record, okay? Now, let me tell you this about this camera too, all right? On the top of this camera right here, there's actually a button that you could press, and it changes right there on the camera from picture mode to movie mode to slow-mo. You can even shoot slow motion on this, okay? And it comes out crisp, okay? So I love this as a vlogging camera. It's really easy to use. It shoots 4K. You could change the lenses on it, and it's amazing. And then when you do upgrade to a bigger Sony, like what I have up here, then you can use the same batteries and the same everything with this, okay? Now, the next thing I want to show y'all is my my tripod. So this is a Manfrotto tripod that I use. It's a little handheld tripod. I could hold it like this. I could open it up and put it down, and it holds. It has really nice grips at the bottom. And this little Manfrotto is like $29, okay? And you can actually angle it however you want to angle it. You could change it. And there's actually an adapter for it. Like if you have your cell phone and you want to use it as a handheld. I know all of the vloggers have the expensive handheld tripod. It's not even a tripod. It's really, yeah, it is a tripod. It's a tripod like this, but you could press record right on it. I don't have time for that. I could easily press record right here on this button. I'm not going to spend an extra $150 for a little tripod. So you could get you one like this. Also in the, let me show you. Also in the Amazon store, I actually put a link to the bigger tripod. Now, this is a tripod I just upgraded to on Amazon. It's $68 and you could get a $6 coupon with it, okay? But the reason why I got this one is because this one has, let me zoom in. You see right here how this is allowing you to put the camera sideways. This is really good if you are filming like any food content inside your house. If you have a camera or a cell phone and you want to film your food, like take a picture or film from the top to the bottom, like with things, let me show you guys. If you have food right here and you want to film from above, you get that particular tripod. You could easily put things on the floor. Like if you're doing makeup, you could put things on the floor. If you're revealing something, you could put it on the floor. And you can actually change the tripod to do multiple different things. It's $68. I just upgraded to that one because the tripod I have my current camera on, she getting old. So I just leave her stationary because she's still functioning. Okay. I'm learning now at this age. Just because I want all these gadgets, I can't be going by all these gadgets, okay? So I went ahead and I'm going to leave that one stationary, leave this camera stationary, and roll around with the new tripod and this camera and this tripod right here. Okay? So definitely go to the Instagram store and you'll see it there. Now, next, as far as mics, okay? As far as microphones, on this camera, there's a little microphone area right here. Okay, you pop it open. And basically what you do is you get your Rode mic. This is in the Amazon store too. And you can leave this little fuzzy on. For those of you that don't know and you see people roaming around with this fuzzy, this is to get rid of all the wind noise. If there's any wind around, it's going to help to diffuse the wind noise around. Okay, so you put it on. And basically what you do is right here, you have this little hot area right here on your camera, this little hot shoot, and you slide your, and I have a flash also that I could use on this, but this is mainly for my microphone. So you slide your microphone on right here, you twist it on tight. It will not show up in your camera because your camera lens will come out when you turn it on. You see how the camera lens comes out? So it's not going to be inside your camera. And then what you do is you take your little cord and you stick it in on the side. Like so. And now you have a functioning working camera with really great audio with this Rode mic. There's other ones out there that looks like this, but I stick with Rode. I make sure that my content, my audio is bar none. Okay. So if you watching me and you wondering what it is I'm doing and how I do it and what, like how I get it done, this is what I do. So when it's time to detach everything, you could just leave this on, but your cord actually detaches also. Okay. What's up, Miss Kathy girl? I love Miss Kathy. Miss Kathy Welch, that's my girl. Okay. So next, what are we going to talk about next? Next. Okay, when it comes to these cameras, this is the most important thing. This is the most important thing. This is why y'all cameras be shutting off early. This is why y'all be taking pictures and y'all SD card fill up fast. Y'all don't know why, because y'all being cheap. Okay? I'm going to put it out there. Y'all cheap. Okay? When you're dealing with the camera with 4K, even 1080p, if your camera is shutting down early, it's getting hot, you take a little bit of video, 10 minutes of video, and it's shutting off. Okay? With this camera, I haven't tested the length of the battery being on, like how long I can record. That's the only thing about the new vlogging camera I'm going to get to test out, like that one, it records like only 10 minutes at a time, which is annoying. With Sony cameras, it can continuously record. That's why you see me do live streams for hours on end and my camera don't get hot. It don't burn out. It's working fine. Okay. And by the way, when you sign up for Internet Street Summit, I'm going to tell y'all where to go get the cameras for cheap. Okay, they ain't gonna have this camera, but the camera I do my live streaming on, I'm gonna tell y'all where to get that for cheap. Okay, now this camera, when you're working with these type of cameras, your SD card cannot be a cheap card. Now, what I used to use these right here, your SanDisk, 64 gigabytes Extreme Plus, and I'm about to show you the difference, because now with this new camera, I changed over and I got the Lexar Professional, okay, SD card. And I'm going to show you the difference between these two because it makes a world of difference, okay? So let me pull this up. Well, let me pull that screen up first. All righty. So let me show you this. This is something that YouTubers don't want y'all to know because they don't want y'all to be great. They want to be the only ones on top, honey. So this is a major, major deal. Okay. You see that price, $29? That's what I used to pay for that sand disk I just showed y'all. 64 gigabytes, I would pay like $29 and think I was getting away with a steal. Okay? Now, what I want y'all to see is, you see right here where it says 60, it says SDXC, it says V60, it has the number 3, it says 250 megabytes per second, okay? And it's 128 gigabytes. When you're dealing with SD cards, majority of the time what you're going to see, you'll see 16 gigabytes, you'll see 32, you'll see 64, you'll see 128, and you'll see 256, okay? That's how much room you could fit on that camera. That's how much space you have on the card, I'm sorry. These cards go into these cameras, but when you're dealing with a camera like this Sony or the one I'm filming on, the problem with it is that you don't have an SD card that can write your content to the SD card fast enough. What's happening is your camera is recording all this information, but the camera may overload because this is taking forever to write. Okay? What does writing mean? Storing the information on the card. So you need something that's going to be able to do that quick and fast. All right? Now let me show you why I switched from SanDisk to this. And it's because of this right here. Where you see the 3 and you see the 60, okay? And you see the 250 megabytes per second. The SanDisk Extreme Plus used to only go up for me 150 megabytes, okay? You see where it says the number 2 on there? I used to have a number 1 on mine. And you see where it says V60? Mine used to say V30. And the number 10 is on there too. Now, each one of these numbers correlate to something. But what I will tell you is, because I'm not well-versed on these SD cards verbatim, what I will tell you is you need this one that I'm showing you. And you better buy it, and you better buy it quick while it's on sale, okay? Because these things are hella expensive. You see the one at the top of the screen right here? It says it was regular price $129 for 67. I'm about to buy that mug. I'm about to buy that mug tomorrow, okay? Tomorrow, okay? Because I need something fast, all right? Now, let me see if I can scroll down and I can show y'all. So you see this one right here? I have some of these too. You see this one right here that says Extreme Pro, 200 megabytes? You see how it says 200 megabytes, SDXC. You see it says V30. It only has a 1 and the number 3. The one I just showed you says 250, okay, megabytes. That means this joker writes super duper uber fast, okay? So I'm going to be buying more of these because you need this in order for it to write the file fast and be able to process all the information and store all the information. You don't want to be in the middle of a vlog and then your SD card, you only film in like 5-10 minutes, and then your SD card says, oh, I'm full. That's because everybody up over there buying them cheap ones. Let me see if I can find one of the little cheap ones. Let me see if I can find, let me come up here and type in SanDisk, and then I'll show y'all. SanDisk. You see this one right here that say Ultra 140? Don't buy that for $18. Oh, that looked like the one April had. Let me get that one. I ain't got $29. You're gonna spend $18.99 and have a crappy ass damn SD card. Instead of just paying the extra $10, $11, and get this one right here, okay? Get the one I just showed you. That's crap. Do not buy that. You see these right here that say Ultra, 32 gig, and you say, oh, I'm getting a 3-pack for $19.99. Girl, there ain't no deal. Your stuff gonna be shutting off. See this Extreme Plus? That's the one I have in my hand. The one I have say 150 megabytes. This will say 170 megabytes. This one is good if you have a 1080p camera, I will say. But you're going to constantly be changing that card. So you may as well just go for the extra dollars and buy the other SD card. Okay? I'm telling you, this SD card is the bomb. All right? Now, the other thing that's in here is these right here. I have these coming in on Friday. And basically what this is I never knew this even existed. This is a battery. Because y'all see sometimes my camera will die in the middle of my live streams. And basically this is a battery that is a dummy battery. I didn't even know these existed until recently. These are called dummy batteries. Okay. Now with these dummy batteries, what happens is you can use this for your camera. You can use it for the ZV-E10. You see it right there. And basically what you do is you plug it in, and let me show you guys what I'm talking about. So right here is your battery, okay? When you open it up, you take it out, you have your battery. That dummy battery is shaped just like this. But what you do is you stick it in, and it's going to have a cord. That cord is going to come out on the side of your camera. You close your case, and then once you close your case, it's a dummy battery, which means you plug it into the wall and you could film till your eyes turn green, okay? You could film until your butt turn raw. You could sit down at that camera and film for 2, 3, 4 hours, however long you want to film. That battery, that camera will not die because it has a dummy battery that's plugged into the wall, okay? So right now, I got my camera plugged up so it stays charging. But the dummy battery is going to be amazing because then I can save my actual batteries from when I'm out vlogging doing this type of stuff. Okay. Now, the next thing I want to show you guys. Okay. No worries. No worries. And like I said, if y'all need consulting, y'all know I'm always here. So if y'all confused on what y'all channel should be or the direction or the content y'all should be putting up, y'all let me know. Because there have been many a days I question what I do here on YouTube. And God has been showing me as of recent, I'm doing exactly what I should be doing, which is sharing the truth, giving comments on certain issues and problems. And even though it seems like a lot of times I'm the underdog on YouTube, because I do see some people that have channels comparable to mine, like in size, and they're getting more views. So I don't know what it is on this channel, why YouTube hates on me so much. I don't know if it's because I'm an old dog that's been on this channel for so goddamn long. I've been on YouTube since 2010 that they like, okay, put it out to pasture. I don't know what it is. But I will be starting a second channel starting in December that I'm going to share all of my YouTube hacks, my Instagram hacks, my TikTok hacks. Because like, for instance, I just posted a video. I posted a video a week ago for me going to see Black Panther. And I did like this little tribute to Chadwick Boseman. And then all of a sudden this week, the video started going viral. I've been having people from, I don't know if it's Mexico or South America, somewhere where they speak Spanish, people are commenting under the post all of a sudden as of today. So it's going viral again. Last week it was going viral in Africa. This week is going viral in some country where Spanish is spoken because there's a lot of people leaving Spanish comments. So at the end of the day, I could show y'all what I do as far as all of this other stuff. Okay. Now, let me show you guys this. Okay. What's up, Rich Legs? Y'all, that's my friend. I don't care what nobody say. Y'all can say what y'all want to say about Rich. Rich, my friend. I love my friend. Thank you for the super chat, Rich. I love you. I love you so much. Okay? So, like, for instance, I don't know if you guys saw this, but I went to Rich Lux's party, okay, for his launch of his new palette. And I vlogged that whole entire situation. And all of that was done on my phone, okay? But a lot of times I want to step it up. So that's why I went ahead and I got me a vlogging camera, because I feel the vlogging camera is a lot better than an actual camera. Okay. So let me show y'all something else that I got. And let me see. Oh, before I get to that, let me show you this. Now, when you get your laptop, and you're going to be editing on your laptop, regardless if you're editing in Premiere Pro or you're editing over in Final Cut Pro, which is my fave. Okay. You need an SSD drive. So the SSD drive, y'all would be done with y'all YouTube videos so quick. Okay. So super fast editing. I am an editing genius. If you guys do not know, I actually filmed my brother's music video. For those of you that don't know, my brother is an aspiring rapper and he's actually really great. He's really, really, really good. But recently when, who was it? PNB Rock passed, I think he's going to hang up his rapping shoes, okay? Because I think he's kind of like not wanting to get into that industry anymore. But let me show you guys really quick. Let me make sure this is muted because I don't want no drama with this thing. So let me pull this up. A lot of you guys don't know, I actually filmed too, okay? So I did this video right here. I filmed it. I edited the video. I did everything myself on my laptop with this SSD drive. The only way I would have been able to do this with this SSD drive, I mean, to edit this video would be with an SSD drive. It allows you to film and edit and upload your videos to YouTube seamlessly. Now, as far as editing and my workflow, I'm going to share that on my other YouTube channel when I get it out there. But when I say editing was a breeze, it was an absolute breeze to edit this video. Okay. This was the best. When I tell y'all, I filmed this video in one day. Okay. We even went up to Mount Charleston and got some shots over here. I got shots of them in my car. My mom and my dad were so shocked. They were like, you let him drive your car? I was like, yeah. I got some shots of him in my car. We went up and I got some shots in Vegas. And then we went up on the mountain while it was snowing and filmed some stuff while it was snowing. And every single thing was edited right here on my desktop. Well, not my desktop, my laptop, okay? And when I tell you my family, my mom, my dad, was so proud of the work that we did off of this video, it was like crazy. So you have to have an SSD drive. You can't have one of those little cheap drives from Amazon just to make it through. No. If you're going to be editing videos, let's say you're editing TikToks or you're editing, you know, your YouTube videos and you want them to be quick, you want them to upload really quick, you're going to need an SSD drive. You work off of this SSD drive. You put everything on this SSD drive so you don't bog down your computer. When you're downloading software, you download it to your SSD drive. Okay? So I'm going to just keep it right there. All right? Now, the next thing I want to show you, if you're really trying to get into travel vlogging, which drone to get, okay? So this is in the Amazon store. I have DJI. I have two drones. I have a Mavic Pro and I have the Mavic Mini. And I'm trying not to buy another drone. I'm seriously not trying. I'm obsessed, okay? The first drone I had, the Mavic Pro, almost took my finger off. You know how you see like people like Casey Neistat reaching up to grab the drone in their hand? Well, it took my whole entire nail off of my finger, okay? So please be careful with these drones. Don't be thinking you Casey Neistat out there, okay? So this drone comes in a case. It's the Mavic Mini. I took it to Hawaii with me. I've taken my drone to Bora Bora with me, flown it from Bora Bora. You have to find out what country you're allowed to fly in, because not every country will let you bring that drone in. And if you make it to their TSA, their check-in in that country. Yes, girl, drama drone. You see, that's why I say I need my friend. I wish my friend lived here. They will confiscate your drone in that country, and you ain't getting it back. Okay? They almost did that to me in Bora Bora because the person that was working the counter didn't know where the drone was. So they almost kept it. I was going to be pissed because I had just bought that drone. So the Mavic Pro that I have, I think I paid $1,500 for that one. This one right here, I think I got for $499. But Amazon made a mistake and didn't charge us. Don't y'all be calling Jeff Bezos and telling them I got a drone for free. I'm just saying. Now, let me tell you why drones are amazing. In Vegas, there's a drone class. Now, this is tea that I'm giving y'all, okay? There is a drone certification class. You have to go to school to fly drones professionally. Don't let nobody be telling y'all to just go fly y'all drones around the airport, around major cities, because you will get fined, and it's a hefty fine, okay? It's a hefty fine, all right? Here in Vegas, there's a drone school. It's like $1,700. They professionally teach you how to fly a drone, and you get an actual drone pilot license, okay? It's like 2 or 3 weekends here in Vegas. I plan on taking that class next year. The reason why I'm taking the class is not just for leisurely flying a drone and knowing the rules and regulations, but eventually there are going to be a lot of jobs opening up. There's going to be jobs on Amazon. There's going to be jobs with Pizza Hut. There's going to probably be jobs with Uber Eats. There's going to be jobs. Think of all the people that go and fly drones for like the Super Bowl and stuff like that. You need to start thinking outside the box, people. Invest in you a drone. If you like drones, if you kind of mesmerized by drones, don't go buy them cheap drones for $100 and some. Just go on Afterpay, go on Klarna, go to Amazon, go to my Amazon store, click on drone, add it to the cart, and pay it over time. Okay? This right here, this little one is good. Do not fly your little drone on a day when it's heavy winds. Okay? Also, with your drones through DJI, they offer an extra insurance that if it falls, if it breaks, they'll replace it. So definitely check into that when you're listing your drone. Okay? Now, let me tell you this. I love my man. I have a very great husband. And that's why I said the other night, that if something was to happen to me, I've already instructed my husband to not have a funeral. I know it would be nice to have a nice funeral if something happened to me and Rich Lux comes down there in his finest, you know, makeup and finest clothes with his pearls and Chanel and Balenciaga and Bottega Veneta. You know, it would be very nice to have Rich Lux come on down there, honey, and do a drama eulogy and do a whole entire thing where he crying over the casket. Trust me, it would be nice. Okay? But no, because I know I got a good man. And ain't no raggedy woman coming up in my house, taking over my man and my child. No. You're not coming to the funeral to try to get Brian. And here's why. Brian was so sweet. Brian bought me a new laptop tonight. Okay? He bought me a new laptop tonight. Brian is a good man. Brian bought me my car. Brian bought me my first house. And Brian bought me a new laptop tonight. Okay? Now, let me tell you something. This laptop is a beast. Okay? Yes. Yes, Bella. Yes. He would start off the eulogy. Rich Lux would start off the eulogy with, "She was a good woman." No, I don't need Rich Lux coming down there and talking about she was a good woman and crying over my casket. Okay? No. So, I want to be cremated. That's what I already instructed my husband. Don't have no funeral. Don't have no services. Just let me be. Okay? And I mean it. So, he bought me a new laptop because I don't know if y'all can hear this when I'm live, but my laptop makes this humming noise. Y'all hear it? It be doing like it want to go on the fritz, okay? So he bought me a new laptop, but let me tell y'all the truth about this laptop. So Brian used to work at Best Buy a long time ago, and Brian knows about open boxes. And what happens is when people buy a laptop and they bring it back, let's say a week, 2 weeks after they bought it, it has to go to open box. So the MacBook Pros, if you can't find one open box, on Amazon right now, they're showing up to be $1,900, okay? I put it in the Amazon store, so just in case they run a sale cheaper than Best Buy tomorrow, you could go through Amazon and get it, okay? Or if you want to look at the specs of what I got, you could go through Amazon and look at it, okay? Now, Bella, I could hear him. She was a good woman, but she was a liar. Rich Lux is crazy, child. So I went over here, and there was an open box. The laptop at Best Buy right now is $1,599. Regular price, $2,000, like $2,2100. Let me show y'all this laptop. So when they put it out, they'll say it's satisfactory. It may have some scratches. It may be worn. And then you have to look at it. Some of them that are in excellent certified condition, you can't even open up the box because it's excellent certified, meaning like the person just bought it and just brought it back the same day, right? They didn't even open it. So it's excellent certified by Best Buy. So you're going to pay close to the actual price. So this laptop is regular price like $2,2100, something like that. Best Buy is running a sale right now where it's $1,599. I got the laptop for $1,400. Okay? It was an open box. So I got the MacBook Pro with the Apple M1 chip, Pro chip. I got the 16 gigabyte, and it has a 512 gigabyte SSD drive. So what these are, that orange thing I just showed you a minute ago, let me just put this stuff back in the box. This right here is called an external SSD. This is an internal SSD on this computer. Now, let me show you the difference. Right now, I have a MacBook Pro 13-inch, but it doesn't have any ports on it. It only has, like, the little turbo, not turbo, what do they call them? They're the little drives that are made like this, the ports for this, right? Annoying. There's only, like, two of those ports, and that's it, and a mic jack. This one comes with the lightning ports on that side. You get two on that side and a mic jack, okay? And then on the other side, you actually get an SD card slot. You get another lightning slot, and you also get a HDMI cord. So if I wanted to plug my camera straight into my computer and record live, I could. If I want to take my other equipment that I have for podcasting and plug it into here, I could. I could do everything right now from here. I can bypass having these dongles on the side and just take my SD card and plug it straight into this slot right here and edit my videos and do what I need to do. This computer is a freaking beast. I actually just got it tonight. As you can see, I got to set it up and do all that other type of stuff. But I just got it tonight. I was going to get the 16 inch, the big one, the big laptop. But I was like, that's too much. Because I have a huge, y'all don't ever see it, but on the side of me over here, I have a huge 27 inch Mac desktop. In my other room, I have a 21 inch Mac desktop. I don't need another big device. I just need something that's small, compact, yet big enough where I can edit and do what I need to do. And trust me, once you go Mac, you never go back, okay? I've been a Mac user for over, I would say I bought my first Mac in like 2007. But I was already using iPhone prior to that, and I've never looked back. I'm still in Mac, and I love Mac products. So I would say definitely you need a laptop, especially for the live streaming portion. If you're going to be coming to Business Vlog Summit, I mean, not Business Vlog Summit, that was my old event, Internet Street Summit, you're going to need a laptop, okay? So while the getting is good, you got Afterpay, you got Klarna, you got Affirm, you got Zip, you got, oh, and another thing at Best Buy that a lot of you guys don't know exists, there's something called progressive leasing where you can do 90 days same as cash. You can actually sign up in the store and they'll do 90 days. As long as you pay it off in 90 days, you don't pay no interest. So there are different ways to get the things that you need to get. And this is it right here. This laptop is a beast, okay? And that M1 chip processor is the fastest processor out there right now, okay? I know there's an M2 chip, but you're talking about paying about $3,000 for a computer of that magnitude. This is enough to get the job done and do what you need to do, okay? So with that being said, let me go back to my page and make sure I covered everything on there, okay? We talked about the drone, we talked about the tripods, the dummy battery, the SD card, the MacBook, the camera, and a Rode mic. These are all the basics to starting your YouTube channel. Most of you could start with your phone and edit from your phone. If you want me to do a video on that, on like how I film and edit from my phone, just to be quick, like my Thanksgiving videos that you guys saw me post today, those were shot on my phone. Those were really quick. I could get to the point really, really fast and shoot it from my phone and edit in my phone. So if y'all want things like that, you could definitely let me know. Okay. Demi said, is the Best Buy deal or deals better than going to Apple site and buying certified refurbished? I've never purchased anything from Apple refurbished certified. What I can tell you is I purchased a lot of things from Best Buy open box, and I've gotten from Best Buy, y'all know those nice stoves, those nice gas stoves with the big grated like stove tops and with the big, huge knobs. My stove was regular price $2,700. I got it from Best Buy open box for $600. Okay. Because somebody didn't measure their stove area and it didn't fit. $600. I've gotten a washer and a dryer. The washer was regular price, I think, $1,800. The dryer was regular price, like $1,700. I got each one for $600 a piece at Best Buy and worked perfectly. Okay? So at the end of the day, y'all, Best Buy is really good when it comes to open box items. Actually, one of my doctor friends the other day, I told him to go to Best Buy. He was able to find some stuff open box there. So definitely Best Buy is the tea. The lights, I'm going to add them after this broadcast. And the SSD drive, I'm going to add this after the broadcast too. Okay. On which box lights to get and also the light bulbs. Okay. But like I said, I'm going to start a separate channel to help you guys, because people be sitting up here trying to teach you, so say, what they know on YouTube, and they don't want to teach you the nitty gritty. They don't want to show. Nothing infuriates me more, okay? And Demi says, yes, so Apple sells return items that haven't been opened or refurbished for 15% off. Yeah, it's a better deal. Because let me tell you something. This laptop right now, you could buy brand spanking new for $15.99. But to get this laptop for $1,400, and there's nothing wrong with this laptop, girl, you, that's like, the laptop is regular price $2,100. That's like $700 off of this laptop. I could not pass it at all. A couple months ago, I bought a 16-inch, and it had a 1 terabyte and everything, and I think I was getting like $200 or $300 off of it open box. We thought it was a deal. But when I came home, I couldn't use it with my live stream and stuff, so I had to return it until I could upgrade my live stream and stuff a little bit better and understand how my live stream was working so I could get a new laptop. So now that I understand all of that, we're going to be rolling this weekend, okay? But yeah, I'll put the box lighting and the light bulbs up after this broadcast, and you could click on it and go in there. I'll put it up within the next like 10, 15 minutes after this broadcast. But I'm going to definitely be on the other channel teaching you guys those things, because nothing makes me more upset than going to a conference, paying a bunch of money, or taking an online course, paying a bunch of money. You get a bunch of handouts. They kind of read or give you a surface level view of how they did things or what they did, and they're not showing you how to actually start. So if you're a person who is shy and you're kind of scared about doing YouTube videos, we're going to test you out going live at the Internet Street Summit. If you're a person, you don't want to be on camera, then I'm going to show you how to do voice type videos also. We're going to get it done. Okay. So at the end of the day, okay, this is what we're rolling with right here, because nothing makes me more upset. I told you guys about that one time I went to Ladies of Success, which is NeNe Leakes' event. I paid, I want to say close to like maybe $1,200, $1,500. I think the original price is like $1,800. I think I managed to get it down to like $1,500 or $1,200. Went to the event and didn't form any bonds with anybody after. It's supposed to be a huge group of women of success. You're thinking you're going to go there and network and meet new women. Nope. We just basically ate shrimp and crabs the whole entire weekend and talk about girl drama. I want my money's worth. And for the amount that this summit is going to be and what you're going to be getting to start a new channel, this is a steal. Okay. So when you go to the Best Buy website, and let me see if I could pull it up. Let me go to Best Buy. Just waiting for it to pick up. Okay. Don't allow. So let's come here. Okay, so you go to your search engine and you see like your favorite store is going to be right here. Okay, so whatever store is your favorite is going to be right here. So you go here and let's say you type in MacBook Pro. And let's say you go for the 16 inch. Okay. If you're looking from your computer, from your desktop, you're going to see an area right here to your left hand side that says open box. You click on that. It's going to show you which ones are open box. You see how it says open box as low as 1800, open box as low as 1700, open box 2800. So what you do is you click on check for availability. Okay. Check availability. And it's going to tell you where it is. So it says unavailable at Maryland Parkway, available tomorrow at a location 12 miles away. So you click on here to see all locations, and it's going to tell you this is the location and this is where you could pick it up on Friday. Okay. So you say pick up here. And then it's going to add it to your cart. And it's that simple. Okay. Now, what I know about Best Buy, even though like you go to Sephora and you go to different places like that and they take your after pay in the store and they take like different methods of payment like that in the store, you need to call your local Best Buy and see which ones they take. Some of them take Affirm, some of them take Apple Pay, some of them only let you do progressive leasing. So you just need to figure out which one is which, okay? And majority of the time, if you get Afterpay, if you approve for a high Afterpay, a high Affirm, or a high Klarna, you can walk in there and do a 90-day same as cash with Progressive Leasing, and you'll get approved. Okay? You're welcome. You're welcome. Night-night, Tammy. Okay? I know I got to go finish cooking too, girl. Okay? Plus, while I'm cooking, I'm going to be watching the season finale of The Kardashians. So let me get my butt up and go start cooking and watch the season finale. So, you know what's the one thing I didn't do today? I didn't pick up no wine. I didn't get any wine. Usually I get wine for Thanksgiving and Christmas. I didn't get any wine today. That's how over I was with this entire Thanksgiving crap. Okay? Yes, definitely check it out. Instead of doing all those payments through your cell phone company, just go there and look for Open Box. Okay? All right? So the summit info is on my in the description box. And basically you go to internetstreetssummit.com. Okay. And when you go to the summit, you're gonna, the way it's going to work is like this. So the summit is in Las Vegas, March 24th. If you sign up for VIP, then that's also March 25th. On March 25th, there will be a VIP event. In this VIP event, you will be able to ask me anything. You'll be able to ask me about money. You'll be able to ask me about sponsors. You'll be able to ask me whatever it is you want to ask me, even down to the cameras. If you still have questions about working your camera or you need a little extra time, those spots will only be open to about 15 people, okay? But the 24th is the main day. So basically what's going to happen with this event, if you go on the website and you read, there will also be these masterclass sessions in January and February. So each month, January and February and March, we're going to have one more prior to the event. And basically what's going to happen is January will be focused on building the foundation of your business, starting your LLC, doing all the necessary paperwork for tax purposes, getting your PO box so you can receive sponsored products and not have people sending stuff to your actual address, and basically laying down the foundation. Then in February, I'm going to show you everything you need to know as far as TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, and even starting your own website. And each one of those sessions, the masterclass sessions, will be an hour and a half, okay? Then in March, the beginning of March, we're going to do another masterclass session before the event. And that's for you to ask any questions prior to you coming to the event. What you need to bring, where you need to get it, where's the cheapest place to get it. I'm going to tell you the cheapest place to get cameras, even cheaper than what I showed y'all. Okay. So we're going to talk about that. All right. But right now, till Monday, if you pay full price for your ticket and you click on this link right here, it'll take you over to the actual ticketing website. Okay, you can use the promo code Black Friday and you get $100 off of the price of the ticket. Now, if you go to the website and you click on payment plan, general admission, or payment plan VIP, it's going to take you over to another website. And on that website, you're able to use Klarna or Affirm. If you use that portion of that website, you get nothing off because you're going to be doing it as a payment plan. Okay, so it is what it is, if that helps you break it up into a payment. But if you pay it up front, the incentive is that you get $100 off. Okay, now if you're in my membership community and you go to the membership community page, I posted today a discount code for you guys to get $150 off of your ticket because I love y'all. I love the people in my membership community so much. So you guys can go over there. But basically, it's going to be a one-day event from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. I am looking into even providing lunch for everybody. If I could get that done, it will be done, and I'll let you guys know when that updates. But I want to try to even make it to a point where we do a work-through lunch where you guys get your lunch, and we're going to keep on working. We're going to keep on trucking through because it's a lot of information to cover. And the reason why I have my summit the way I have it is because I'm tired of people going to summits. I'm tired myself of going to events, getting there, learning all this information, and then I get home and I don't know how to apply or use that information. So I want it to be when you walk out that door, you know how to go live, you know how to film, you know how to get stuff done on your channel, okay? So that's the purpose of this event, okay? And you can get the link to that in the description box. Okay. And that's going to be here in Las Vegas next year in March. And actually, my birthday is the day before that. My birthday is the 23rd. So we might just do a little something that night to celebrate and party. Okay? Because it's going to be lit. I turn 45 next year, honey. It's going to be lit. Okay? It's going to be lit. All right? 45, we going on and tear the year down. Okay? It's going to be the year of the mother. Okay? So here's the deal. You don't have to get your LLC before starting this stuff. You can start now. You need to get your stuff so you can start. And as time goes on, then you worry about getting your LLC. That's the way I did it. That's the way I did it. When I first started YouTube, we didn't know nothing about no LLC. We just would use our social security number and get it done. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, in order for you to even get a check from YouTube, I think they changed the rules now where you have to have 1,000 subscribers and also 4,000 watch time hours. But let me tell y'all something is changing on YouTube come February. And a lot of influencers don't want y'all to know this. And what is it, April? All of those YouTube shorts that people are doing, if you notice, a lot of people are posting YouTube shorts. That's because starting February, YouTube shorts will be monetized and people will be getting checks. Big checks, okay? And it's going to be easier for you to become monetized through YouTube shorts than through starting just a regular YouTube channel. So the time is now to start creating content and get it done, okay? Bella says, so you're doing more than one event or more than one date is available? No. So what I'm doing is the actual event is March 24th when you're going to have to be here in person to see everything. January, February are your courses online. We're going to do a live Zoom where you guys will be in with me and we're going to do a class. One class in January, one class in February, and then a Q&A session in March. And then you will arrive here in Vegas March 24th. And if you want to stay through the 25th to do the VIP session, then you stay through the 25th, okay? But at the end of the day, I want y'all to see it because me just doing classes, people just doing class, it still don't answer those questions when you're plugging things into your computer, you're going live, and you're like, why isn't this working? Why is it not connecting? Okay, let me come over to your computer and see what's what. Let me come over to your computer and take a look at it and tell you what's wrong with your computer, okay? So I'm going to tell you now, if you ain't got no computer that's up to date, you may as well stay at home. And I'm going to just keep it 1,000% honest with you. If you're just going to edit from your phone and do everything from your phone, welcome. Come on in. But if you're going to show up with a laptop and that laptop is like a 2001, girl, stay at home with that laptop and just bring your phone. Okay? And then we'll figure it out from there. All right, because what I'm not about to do is have y'all show up, get there, and then y'all be like, oh, well, y'all come back on YouTube or go back somewhere to some drama channel. Oh, I attended April event, but she couldn't help me. She said my laptop didn't work, or they won't even say my laptop wouldn't work. They would just say she couldn't help me. You won't say your laptop is old as fish grease. You're going to just sit there and be like, well, she couldn't help me. Stay at home, girl. If you come in here for a soundbite, if you come into this event for some drama, it's not going to happen for you. So you may as well sit your ass at home, okay? And the reason why I'm doing these master classes prior to is because I want to see all y'all faces. I want to get acquainted with the people that's attending my event because a lot of people from YouTube, that they quality ain't that great, they going to send somebody to come and be a mole in there and learn and come back. So I want to know everybody's faces, okay? Everybody's faces when you come up in there. Oh, no, fish grease, okay? None. Y'all know I am very much protective of my intellectual property, honey. I do not play when it comes to my intellectual property. what I know, how my setup is, what camera is up there, what lens is up there, what mics I'm using, what all I'm using. And this next thing I'm about to add this weekend is going to blow y'all mind. All that stuff I'm using, that's called intellectual property. You know why? Because I sat right here on my channel and had to learn how to do it myself. It took weeks. It took months. It took investing in a lot of stuff for me to get on that level. So you just can't pop up and just think I'm just going to teach you like that. It don't work like that. Yes, January, Zara X. So January and February are part of the program. Yes, ma'am, it is. So you're going to be getting your session for January. You're going to get your session for February included, because I have to prep you before you come. We have to be in the mindset that when you arrive in Vegas, ready to go to this class, you are ready. We're not just doing all this back work that day of asking all these questions, okay? You're going to be ready by the time you walk through that door. And trust me, my venue is bar none. My venue is stellar, okay? For those of you that want to check my receipts, okay? I don't have no deleted tweets, but I got receipts, okay? I'm not shabby on what I pay for. And the way it goes is, with my events, I don't care if it's five people, you're going to get the same service as if it was 1,000, okay? All of that canceling events because only five people show up. Girl, sit down somewhere, okay? Now, let me show you real quick. I do not play. Let me pull this up. So this is the venue here in Las Vegas. It's called Meet Las Vegas. You could call a number. You could verify that my event is there. Yes, it is. Okay. I don't be saying I'm doing events and there ain't no recollection and no receipts of a venue person being at this venue. Okay. This is what it looks like on the inside. You could pretty much make it whatever you want it to be. But let me see. I could pull up some pictures of what it's going to look like on the inside. So this is what your classroom is going to look like. Okay. Y'all bring your laptops and this is what it's going to look like. And actually it's going to look a little bit better than that because I'm going to jazz it up a little bit like I did at my last event. But basically this is what to expect. So this is a bigger venue downstairs, but we're going to be on the second floor. And there's even a computer lab. And a computer lab, I was thinking about getting it, but I don't like the way it looks, child. It ain't aesthetically pleasing like the other area. The other area is aesthetically pleasing. So that's what we're rolling with. Because y'all can't use some people's computers no way anyway to be live streaming and stuff like that. So basically, this is what the venue is. This is what it looks like on the inside. I love this place. I've been working with them for years. And it's my go-to place here in Vegas that I go to and host events. So this is Meet LV. It's going to be in downtown Las Vegas. The address is actually on the website, on the Internet Street Summit website. And basically, you could go there and just basically check it out, see what you think, and this is what to expect. I'm not going to have y'all in somebody's basement. I don't know if y'all heard that there was a girl that did an event, a social media influencer event to teach people how to be on social media. And she did it from her mama's basement. And from what I heard, she was like serving Tostitos and like, what y'all be doing out there? Why do people pay to go crap? Like, why y'all pay to go to stuff like that, man? Okay. I can't. All right, but I just want to come on, okay, and tell you guys, and yes, Demi, there will be more than five people, child, because let me tell you, my last two events, I had 100 plus people show up, so trust me, it's going to be more than five people, I know that. As we get closer to the event, it's going to sell out. I'm already selling tickets. I've been getting alerted via email that you guys have been purchasing tickets, so and paying full price. So thank you so much for doing that. Well, not the full price, but paying up front is what I'm saying. A lot of you have been paying up front, but I wanted to make it feasible for you guys where you would be able to do a payment plan and you would also be able to just pay outright if that's what you wanted to do and make it a feasible amount for everybody. I know initially I was going at a higher bracket, price bracket, because I know my worth and I know what y'all about to get. But at the end of the day, I did hear some of you guys saying, well, it's a little bit expensive for me. And that's why I decided to give you guys such a deep discount for Black Friday, because I want y'all to be in attendance. I want y'all to create videos. I want you to start your channel, because there's a lot of people about to get laid off come next year. And you need to have that extra stream of income coming in. So that's the reason why I decided to go that route. Demi says, will you consider doing online class too? Nope. The only online portion will be the January and February dates. The actual in-person class to learn how to live stream with all the equipment I have and how to edit from your phone and film from your phone is all in person. I cannot teach you that from social media, because what I don't like is people coming to classes online and saying I didn't learn ish. I didn't learn nothing. I already knew that stuff. I've been in people classes where they did that. I had one girl charge a class to say it was going to be the best Instagram class ever. She was going to divulge everything. She specifically said that when she was promoting this class. I paid $199 for this class, and I got there to the class. And there were over 1,000 people in this class, and there were a lot of people asking not dumb questions, but simple questions that you could go and Google. And she would take time answering everyone. This class went from 11 a.m. that Saturday morning and did not get over till 5. It was only supposed to be an hour and a half class. That class did not finish until 5 p.m. And I was very pissed because I gave $199. And this was stuff that I already knew as an influencer. So it really pissed me off that I just basically gave my money away to somebody. So I don't do online stuff because I don't know who these people is coming up in my classes that's from online. It could be my competition here on YouTube, and I'm not going to sit here and sell myself short and sell my intellectual property to somebody. That's what I'm not about to do. And they could try to send people to come and watch and see what's going on, but them people don't know what they're doing either. They don't know what they're doing either. So at the end of the day, it is what it is. Okay. And when I say don't know what they're doing either, meaning they don't know how to go back and explain to them everything that I'm doing. You said it, I didn't, Jane. Okay. Rich, I took that masterclass too, girl. Let me tell y'all something about Kris Jenner masterclass, okay? So my first conference, I had, I want to say, 7 sponsors. And I'm going to get ready to end this live. I'm going to end it on this. I had 7 sponsors. One of the sponsors was WeTV. I secured a deal with WeTV. The person that connected me to WeTV was shocked that they even gave me money. WeTV sponsored my event. They gave me $1,000. This other company sponsored and gave us over $5,000 worth of free products to put in goodie bags. This other company that came gave me a kickback from some of the stuff they sold at my event. Okay. So needless to say, I made a lot of money off of sponsorships. Kris Jenner, in my opinion, allegedly made money off of sponsorships too, because it was a lot of businesses that were mentioned in her handout. Where's the damn handout? I have that handout around here somewhere because I printed it out after the class. I don't know where I put that handout at, but basically in the handout, there were so many celebrities and businesses that she shouted out that it gave me the vibes of like when Star Jones got married to Al Reynolds and she was getting all this free stuff from sponsors just to name drop them on The View. I'm just saying. I believe the universe is going to come through for you, Demi. The universe is going to come through for you, honey. God is going to come through for you. You're going to be there, honey. I'm just saying, child. Jane, I already know you ain't got to tell me, girl. You ain't got to tell me. They're not going to... Let me make y'all understand about some people. Okay? Let me tell y'all something about people. People will sell y'all the moon. Okay? And leave all the stars, all the planets, the sun and earth, all out of it. And all of those things create the universe. Okay? I'm going to tell you again. Some people sell the moon and will leave the stars, the planets, the sun, the earth out of it. And that's all what creates this universe. Okay? So at the end of the day, I'm not coming with this summit to just do a cash grab. This ain't no cash grab. This is literally things that I've learned. If you would see my setup in my workstation here, it would have you shook, okay? If you would actually see the receipts of all the stuff I bought up in here, it would have you shook, okay? If you think we just got 1,400 lying around to buy a laptop, you got life mixed up. That's Brian's hard-earned money that he felt he wanted to buy that for me as an early Christmas gift to further my brand and further what I'm doing. When people see what you're doing and that you're being successful at doing what it is you're being called to do, they're going to invest in you. They're going to support you. If you ever been a person that sit here and be like, why doesn't my friend support me? I'm always supporting them, but they don't ever support me. It's probably because they don't see that you're really serious about what it is that you're trying to do. But the minute that they see that you're eager and you're willing to do the work, they will invest in you. Okay? So, I'm looking down at my laptop because I'm ready to play with it. At the end of the day, you have to invest in yourself. And just like I come on here and I rip Kim Kardashian a new butt, I rip this one and that with a new butt, I ride Kris Jenner into the sunset, I'm not finna sit up here and criticize these people and then sit up here and do some janky ASS type conference. That's what I'm not about to do because ain't nobody coming finna rip me nothing, okay? If it's one person come out of there with some fake ASS drama and I got 20 other people that done attended and could tell you different, then you believe the people that was there that's telling you different than that one person, okay? So at the end of the day, that's what I'm bringing to the table. I have been a person that I've been taken advantage of. I've been a person that I've given money. In the last year, I've taken 3 courses or going to 3 events, and out of those 3 events, I've not gotten anything. Nothing. I took one person's course that was to be held in Dallas, and the pandemic happened right around that time. I still could have got on a plane and go. They hadn't shut down the city. They hadn't shut down the world yet. And I was that tempted to go. And I said, no, Lord, let me stay my butt here. And she still had the event. She bought them food. I think it was Chick-fil-A or something. And then all the other events and the people that didn't show up, later on she had the conference online. Or not conference, a workshop online. And I was so eager for this workshop. And then I took it and I didn't learn anything. It was pretty much like Jane is saying, I didn't learn anything. I gave her $300 for nothing. And she didn't even as much as her other 2 events, she bought, you know, the group Chick-fil-A, you could have at least sent out $5, $10 gift cards to people and tell people here, go buy your lunch at Chick-fil-A so that way when we do the event online, you'll be able to eat with us and we'll do a work through lunch. That's what I would have done. But not everybody has that level of hospitality. Not everybody has that level of thinking because for me, if I can pull off doing lunch for everybody, I will because think about it. The amount of time is going to take you, if I say, okay, you got an hour for lunch, the amount of time it's going to take you to get downstairs, go across the street, go to the brunch place across the street, get something to eat. You can't bring food back into the venue. You're going to have to eat outside or at the place that you're going to. Then you're going to have to come back in. You're going to have to refresh. I'm going to have to get everybody to be back focused. Everybody going to be full with food and with the itis. I would rather you work through the lunch. So at the end of the day, okay, it is what it is. All righty. Carol, you better show up. Look here, Carol. You better show up. Carol, come kick it with me for my birthday, girl. It's my birthday weekend. Come kick it with me, girl, with your Yeezys. Carol and her Yeezys from the Goodwill. Carol is a mess. Yes, and you can apply all this live streaming stuff to your Zooms, too. And if you are a professional that works at a job and y'all need to step up y'all game on y'all Zooming and y'all live streaming, then this is the conference you need to go to, because you can actually apply that to your jobs also. Okay. Thank you, Madison, because it is true. And thank you for spelling your name with one D like my child. These people be with these two D's and these Y's and two S's and two N's. Child, please. Oh, well, Carol, come on down. Let's party. Carol, DM me on Instagram, girl. Let's party. Okay? I'm going to DM you on Instagram. Let's party, girl. And make sure no other questions need to be answered. Girl, you a mess, okay? Y'all are a mess. That's why I love y'all. When is the deadline? So the cutoff for the tickets for the $100 off is Monday, okay? The cutoff for the tickets for the $150 off for the members only is Monday. Regardless, if you join, you buy your ticket now, you buy your ticket, let's say the first week in March before the event, is fine. Because that information in January session and February session will be recorded and you can reference back to that information then. Okay? So that's totally fine. Girl, yes. Let me tell you something. I don't like March Madness. I don't. It interferes with my birthday festivities. March Madness is a bad taste in my mouth. When I met Brian, I made sure he wasn't into March Madness because I had an ex who was into March Madness and he would always put my birthday on the back burner to watch March Madness. So I don't like March Madness. We're going to make it Mother Madness. That's what we're going to do. Okay? I'm just saying. So, any other questions, comments, whatever? Because I'm getting ready to end this broadcast. We went too long. We went an hour and 28 minutes, child. Okay? These long broadcasts be killing my channel. They be killing my channel, honey. My channel can't live. So just from speaking, I would tell you your laptop and your cell phone. Any other items that I mention, okay, at this event, I'm going to bring my whole setup so you guys can see the whole entire setup, okay? We're even going to live stream live from the actual event. So the thing about it is everything else is going to be there for you to see the setup. I don't want you to go buy all of the live streaming equipment and you realize, you know what, I really just don't want to do live streaming because this costs a lot of money. Or I'll just live stream from my cell phone or live stream some other way. Or I don't want to live stream. I just want to vlog. That's easier for me. So I would say definitely bring your laptop, your cell phone, and maybe even your camera. So that way, like, let's say you have this camera and you buy it. And let's say you're looking at it and you don't know the functionality on how to set the settings in the camera. I will set your settings for your camera there live. Trust me, it's from 8 to 5. This is not going to be a huge class. There will be enough time for me to cover all of y'all and get all of y'all squared away in time. And those of you that want extra time, you can sign up for the VIP event. And then, like I said, for the first couple of people that purchased tickets, they were getting live consultations. So I'm feeling generous. I might let a couple more people into the consultations and let y'all get that, because I would rather give more consultations away for free with y'all purchasing y'all ticket than y'all show up and not have everything together. Okay. So with that being said, you guys, y'all have a blessed day, evening or night, whatever time of the day it is that you're watching. I'm going to go and watch the Kardashian season finale. I'll be back on later to talk about that caca and get my food to cooking up in here. My turkey, my roast, my ham. I got green beans, yams. I ordered my mac and cheese from somewhere because I really didn't have time to do mac and cheese today. Last time I made it, it was too salty. The time before I made it, it was too bland. So I said, this time I'm going to leave it to the professionals, okay? Because I'm not a big mac and cheese person. But yeah, yams, green beans, cornbread dressing, and rice dressing. So I got a lot to do, okay? Thank you so much, Madison. I truly appreciate it, okay? Happy Thanksgiving to everybody. Thank y'all all for watching my YouTube shorts from today. I got some more I got to post in a little bit. But with that being said, you guys, y'all have a blessed Thanksgiving, and I will see you guys in the next broadcast in about another hour. So see y'all later. Bye.